Welcome to Midwest Sportsnet. Hi, I'm Joey McWilliams, and we are continuing to preview the college football season in 2021. Today, we get to go to Winfield, Kansas, and stop and visit with the head football coach of the Southwestern Moundbuilders, Coach Brad Griffin, in his seventh season. Coach, last year, you got pretty much a full season, and I know maybe a hiccup or two along the way, but to get nine games in, I think, is something to speak of, number one, and then to go 7-2, a quality year, 5-2 in the KCAC, finishing with a number 24 ranking in the postseason poll. Not only that, you win your last three. So it seems to me, at least from the surface, that last year turned out to be successful for the program.
Yeah, you know, we felt pretty good about it. We lost a couple close ones that, you know, we definitely could have made a play here too, and maybe could have ended up on the other end of things. But with the way the season went and, you know, practicing a week and getting a game canceled and going through that through the fall and the spring, I mean, overall to be able to get nine games in and, you know, we had a pretty heavy senior-led team and was happy that those guys got to play as many games as we could. So, but yeah, overall, a good year for us. And, you know, we're excited to see if we can build off of that.
Well, one of those seniors that is heading out, though, I'll mention this, Grant Torgerson, senior linebacker, recently named Academic All-American. So that's always something nice for the program when you know, players like that and quality players like that perform in the classroom as well.
Yeah, Grant was just been nothing but a stud for us for the last 4 years, on and off the field, you know, getting it done academically in the classroom. And, you know, obviously was a really good player for us at the linebacker spot. And he'll be somebody that'll be tough to replace. He's was a really good player in our conference for, you know, for his time here. So, but he's moving on to bigger and better things and getting ready to go to grad school and all that. So, but yeah, we'll definitely need to, we'll be looking for the next one.
Well, we'll talk about the defense here in just a moment. Let's start on the offensive side of the ball. And I think actually on both sides of the ball, you get to talk about the Jones boys, and you have plenty of them, senior leadership from those guys as well. Keyshawn Jones, Andre Jones on the offensive side of the ball, leading the way, your two top receivers, they're coming back. And, you know, also I think it will be a big plus for you to have Keyshawn Wyatt back in the running back position. Those guys really did well for you all last year.
Yeah, you know, when we get those guys back, and Keyshawn was kind of something that we've been working on a little bit. He indicated that he wanted to continue and play, and so we're excited to get him going. And obviously, the other Keyshawn Jones and Andre were very productive for us in the fall. I mean, Keyshawn's electric. He gets him in space. He's tough to tackle. And you know, Andres was kind of a big play guy for us to have a bigger outside receiver. You know, he just made some plays for us. So, and then Marquise on the defensive end. Yeah, he's definitely somebody on the edge that, you have to account for. You know, he had a really, really good year the year before in 19, and he, you know, people kind of, cued on him a little bit more this last year. So maybe his production was down a little bit. But, you know, if he's demanding double teams, that's just helping out his teammates. So excited to have all those guys back.
Well, that makes a big difference. And that's something that obviously other people have to step up. You're exactly right. Here on Midwest Sportsnet, we're on the summit today, and we're visiting with Brad Griffin from Southwestern in his seventh season with the program. And we appreciate it if you consider subscribing to the channel. We cover small college sports here on Midwest Sportsnet. You know, you went ahead and went over to that defensive side of the ball with Marquise Jones, and we've already talked about the fact Torgerson has moved on. Jones is drawing a little bit more attention, may lead the way, though, for someone like a Caleb Helsley to step up. I mean, he did a fantastic job for you last year, 12.5 tackles for loss, 4 sacks, leading returner in tackles on the team as well. So, you know, there is a lot of strength coming back there for you on defense.
Yeah, Caleb was outstanding last year, you know, just having that presence on the edge, a guy that you can count on to – you know, to set the edge of the defense, and he can play some coverage as well, and kind of does it all. And in a spot that we We utilize a lot on defense, and Caleb was just an outstanding player. And we have another senior coming back as well. Clayton Downham has been a 3 or 4 year starter for us as well. And so he's coming back at linebacker. So we'll have, from the spring, we'll have 3 or 4 starters back at linebacker. And we'll probably lose a little depth on the defensive line, but we're got some good young players. And then I would say probably our biggest question potentially would be where we're going to be at in the secondary. We lost an All-American, Marcus Richard. And he was a really good player for us this last year. And so, but, you know, we've been recruiting over the last few years, so we feel like we've got some pretty good young players coming up as well.
You know, it is pretty interesting, Coach, when you talk about coming back from the spring and it's not your spring game. I mean, it's part of the schedule there as well. Did having games in the spring take a toll on your team and as to how you're heading into, you know, camp right around the corner?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, football was definitely made to be played in one semester, in my opinion. It was a long year for our kids. I really think if we just would have played in the fall, we may have had, you know, we had about 25 seniors and we only have 2 or 3 of those guys that graduated that are going to come back and go to grad school. So I think if we would have not had that in the spring, we may have had a few more of those guys want to come back. I felt like they felt we played 2 seasons, you know, because we were practicing, I don't remember how many weeks we practiced, but we used them all up to play our 9 games. And so, and you know, we had some injuries in the spring with Cagle, our quarterback, got injured in the spring. If that happens in the fall, we'd probably get him back. It's going to be tough for us to get him back this fall, at least at the start of the year. You know, and we had a defensive end get hurt in the spring that would probably be back as well. But so, yeah, it definitely it took a toll on, you know, not only just physically, but mentally as well. And just a long year. So quick turnaround, was a short summer, for sure, but it's here, and so we're all getting ready to go.
Well, there may be some questions then, it sounds like, to answer in camp, and that's right around the corner. But the schedule is, too, and you guys get underway in all KCAC schedule for 2021, and it starts at home at Jantz Stadium on September 4th as you all take on Ottawa. And your first trip on the road to Lindsborg, facing Bethany on September 11th. Can you talk about the opening to your schedule?
Yeah, definitely going to see a very, very good Ottawa team. We played Ottawa the last game of the year this past season, and we were fortunate enough to go to their place and come back with a victory. And they had some really good young players, and I think they're going to be really tough for us. So, I mean, and they play a game before we do. We don't have a game scheduled as of right now prior to our September 4th game. So, that's kind of, you know, my old coach used to tell me the most improvement you make is from game one to game two. So we'll be there game two. So we'll have to be ready to go. So, and then with, you know, not seeing much of Bethany last year and them not playing in the spring, they're kind of the unknown, I would say, in the conference. So it'll be interesting to see what they have, you know, in store for us as well.
Well, it all gets underway for you all again September 4th. So fans of the Mound Builders, get ready, because you'll have an opportunity to see your team at home in week one in September 4th. And that's a Saturday evening game. Both those first two games are evening games. Coach Brad Griffin, thank you very much for taking time with us today here on the Summit, and success to the Mound Builders this year. Again, a strong season last year, finishing at number 24 in the poll, maybe just outside of the playoff picture there. As you were talking about, things change a little bit different one way or the other. That's what you're looking for in 2021. But thank you for taking time with us.
No, I appreciate it, and thank you for the support.